In this video, first we'll go over the differences between Redis Streams and Redis Pops Up. Then we'll run a benchmark in AWS comparing performance of these two, measuring latency, throughput, as well as saturation. Also, I'll explain how you can achieve over 1 million messages per second using a single-threaded Redis deployed on the VM with only one CPU. The biggest difference between these two is that Redis Pops Up is completely stateless. It's like a stateless proxy. Messages are only available to consumers when they publish to Redis topic. So in case there are no consumers or one crashes for some reason, if the producer sends a message to the topic where no one is listening, those messages will be lost forever. On the other hand, we have Redis Streams, which is a data structure on its own. When the producer publishes messages, they are placed in the queue and stored in the memory. In that case, consumers can read those messages even after they get disconnected. And you can also create consumer groups to read from the same topic. I run all my benchmarks on AWS, and you can see that I used medium instances based on Graviton for Redis, which have one CPU and 4 GB of memory. I also have EKS cluster with a bunch of nodes to run my clients and monitoring components. Alright, let's go ahead and run the test. First of all, I'll create one producer and one consumer for streams and pops up. We'll start with around 1000 messages per second, and you can immediately notice that it takes much more CPU for Redis Streams to handle this volume. Well, again, Redis Streams is a durable queue, whereas Pops Up is just a stateless proxy with minimal functionality to support producers and consumers. Latency is also higher for streams, but it's very low latency in both cases, between 100 and 200 microseconds. Let me run this test for maybe a minute, and then we'll go over each graph. You can see a trend that Pops Up is lightweight and can handle way more messages per second. Before trying to achieve full throughput, let me go over each graph. We have latency, which we measure using P90 percentile, and even at this level, we have quite low latency, under 1 millisecond. So at this point, we have only 17,000 requests per second. By no means is it the maximum throughput. Next, we have CPU usage, which indicates that streams would have much less throughput based on the CPU trend. Next, we have memory usage. Well, Pops Up does not store anything, so memory usage stays flat. By the way, messages in streams do not expire, and you need to manually delete them, or you can use max len property when you publish messages to a stream. Now, let me show you the final results where I was trying to create as many clients as possible to achieve the highest throughput possible for streams and Pops Up. Since Pops Up is a stateless, I was able to increase the throughput to over 1 million messages per second using a single-threaded Redis instance on one CPU. I don't think anything else can come close to it. And with Redis Streams, I was able to achieve only around 54,000 requests per second, which is expected and still a very nice result for one instance. So if you can tolerate the loss of the messages, you would be better off with Pops Up. Otherwise, go with Redis Streams.